you're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the U. Man, know that I kick up the U. Them way there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? Look, you're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the U. Man, know that I kick up the U. Them way there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? Wanna come round here like a bad boy, do it. Run all the talking, go on and do it. Running through the party, but look, balls in my ear saying spoons, don't do it. Double on my shoulder, I don't lack. Hitting with a business, I don't scrap. Even when I'm far, I'm so easy ride, but there's no car and no mash.
What are you talking about?
Clown, stand down. Never had a thing, never had a pound. You were never bad then, you ain't bad now. Never had them, had a then. Look, look back down. Wait, I saw bare kicks, saw bare clothes. Said not that, I can't wear those. I don't like them, they're not my thing. They went silent, they're all weirdos. Like, yeah, spoons don't clear. Never had a Tom Ford or a Montclair. Man, them a car, but you see my don there. Tell them don't do it, don't dare. Don't care who you know from my block. You're not Al Capone, they can take my car and my creps. I'll still do the road in my socks. Like, who's gonna stop me? You, him, little man. I got blue slims. Don't be an idiot, move smart. I've been killing it, new king. You were never ready for my new stuff. You're a boy by yourself, go and group up. And when crep went states for the BTs, I was covering crep like a boot cut. If mad, it's a family thing, straight family thing. Dumb man, I broke no salary thing. Had a young team called Amy telling me to come round hers on a Valerie thing. Hashtag Murky Academy thing. You were like art and the gallery thing.
Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden Ultimate Team. On deck, we've got a great matchup in store between the Seattle Seahawks and the Wizards. The Wizards enter this one knowing that this game could very well be won or lost down in the trenches. From an offensive perspective, they'll need to keep their quarterback upright to have a chance. And defensively, it's going to be about containing the running game.
What a surprise here. There's rain in Seattle as we're off to CenturyLink Field to link up with our broadcast team of Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Back to throw. On the screen, this is Coleman. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. He's back to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they're able to bring him down at the 20. Call it a one-yard gain on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down. He'll look to throw. Open, and there is Patterson complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They'll get 32 yards there. And it's good enough for a first down.
We know it's tough enough to pick up first downs on third down plays, but when you go for it on fourth down, sometimes you're actually just praying. And on that play, the prayer was answered.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Back to throw. Steps away to his left. And some room to work. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. 12 more yards there and another first down. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movements. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
Now they go screen. It's complete. And we've got a timeout. 9 seconds remaining. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock. Now one more shot at it. Obviously, again, they've got to go for the end zone.
Well, we've seen it happen before. How about Aaron Rodgers? Throughout his career, he seems to pull it off about every other week. But if I'm the defense, I'm rushing the quarterback and making him move away from his throwing arm. That makes it a little bit tougher to get it downfield.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is incomplete. So no miracles here on the final play. And this ball game is over. Well, Charles, they were close in the end, but they couldn't get that last play, that last little miracle play done. They were within striking distance, but couldn't find a way to... And the offense readies for a first down and 10. First and 10, Wade forced out to his left. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the... Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
And that one, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to come up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
The drive begins with a run by Rawls. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. And before this play happens, we're going to get a timeout here. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. On third down, Procise. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Here's John Ryan now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And now a high kick, but he hit it straight up. So possession goes over here on the punt. And control of the football switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. A swing pass caught. And he gets into the end zone for the touchdown. Emmanuel Sanders with 4 seconds remaining. And his guys are just an extra point away now from taking the lead in this game.
I don't think there's any great secret or mystery here. We're in the fourth quarter. You've got to take that shot, especially since you're down on the scoreboard. But I have to understand what was going on defensively. They've got to know that as well, don't they?
Absolutely, but they look lost defensively, and they took that shot, got in the end zone, now in position here to take the lead. Tyler Lockett now with a return. Well, this one, partner, was fun down to the very end. They got the points late, right before the whistle. Then the ensuing kickoff. They were hoping for magic on the other side, but couldn't get that spark.
Fun if you won, and fun for us.
Picture me putting my city all over the map. There wasn't believers, I had to get even in mind. We coming up, pulling up, jumping.
your grass. So tell them I got a new girl. Tell the that I'm in the bank and I want all my 50s in cash. I'm tired of living check to check. I need 20 models. This is smiling in my grave, fresh to death. I've been Wu-Tang with a Spectre deck. Getting, yeah, I gotta just get off my chest. I cannot miss it, got less on my list and you next. Take it how you want it. I ain't famous like I want it, but I think I might just skirt off. Blow the speakers and turn off. Pop up. Go to church with my shirt off. Tell the Lord that I'm here now. I've been waiting for so long. I've been patient for so long. Breaking rules like there's no laws, and I did it for a long time. If you don't like me, take a ticket. There's a long line. Nice to meet me. I think the pleasure's all mine. They've been clocking me so long. I think they lost time. Ooh, you lost, lost, lost. What you mean? Woo.
Hello, everybody. Larry Ridley welcoming you to Madden Ultimate Team. It's the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up, we've got a good one in store between the Wizards and the San Francisco 49ers. The Wizards are going to take the field here tonight with the...
And now the offense getting set, first and 10. Throwing on first down, Wade. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10.
Partner, you've got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Solomon Thomas in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he is in as they have tied it late here in the final minute of the fourth quarter.
We all knew the situation. We're in the fourth quarter. Who's going to step up and make the big play? Well, we just saw it, didn't we? Took their shot downfield, got it, and now they're in a great position to take the lead.
And they have taken the lead here in this fourth quarter. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock, a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. The Niners on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is 3rd and 7.
Hurry up, here we go.
Now Hoyer. And he finds McDonald. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. It's going the other way. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball, so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. Being chased, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know people.
Too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run. I was born for this.
Whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down.
Run me like a racehorse, pull me like a ripcord, break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip, word upon you. hypothetical, working onto something that I'm proud of. Out of the box, an epoxy to the world and the vision we've lost. I'm an apostrophe. I'm just a symbol to remind you that there's more to see. I'm just a...
EA Sports coverage of the NFL is on the air. I'm your host, Larry Ridley, and this is Madden Ultimate Team. On deck, we've got a great matchup in store between the Wizards and the Kansas City Chiefs. The Wizards come into this challenge game knowing that they're in for a dogfight. And you can bet the coaching staff will be preaching all of the buzzwords.
And the Chiefs offense ready to go on first down and 10. Now Smith. They'll leave this for Ware. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Give him six on the play, and it's a second down. And with the clock ticking under 50 seconds now, he spikes it. The Chiefs on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is third and 4. Now it's Smith. Looking left side and completing it to Thomas. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. And did he just clock that? Looked like he tried to stop the clock, but the clock wasn't even moving. Smith. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Spencer Ware, the intended target, and it'll bring up third down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Smith now to throw. The tight end Kelsey has it over the middle. And oh, he coughed it up, and this is picked up by the defense. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. He didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
They'll start out on the ground with Coleman. Shedding through the defense. Got some room at the 30. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They go play action here on first down. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the... He's got it! Hit the 15! And he's across for the late touchdown. And in the final seconds, that one should just about put a capper on this game. So a little icing on the cake there before the clock hits all zeros.
What a way to finish things off. Exactly what you want. Not much time and a touchdown to put things away.
Looking to throw. Warner.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. I liked it when they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and he's going to get two. That's great. But from the 15, the risk reward, it's just not there.
It's so risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
Well, in this one, partner, we had some action.
So many. My girl show me love, she know I make sacrifices. And if it's real, real love, then you make sacrifices. To get ahead, man, you gotta make sacrifices. That's how hungry my appetite is. Yeah, yeah. What you telling me? I sense the jealousy. I got telepathy. I got the recipe. I got the streets and I don't got no felony. Forward thinking, yeah, my mind is ahead of me. Mama said it's gonna be whatever you let it be. It's some homies I grew up with that's dead to me. It's some that I just made a debt to me. What's in common is they both pay respect to me. I get in my way from Friday to Friday. My girl is a mix of Aaliyah and Sade. I came a long way from that Marvin and I pull out the driveway like I'm in a car chase. Speed it. And if my she know I'm leaving. No text, no call, but at airplane mode. Cold, no pea coat, no time to change clothes. Same clothes, love if you're living by the same code. G code, leave, you dead to me, back to my destiny. Penthouse, bird's eye view, that's a nest for me. I got myself out of debt, so when you see me, know you somebody I never need. Sacrifices, so many sacrifices.
Straight up.
I done gave up so much free time, knowing time ain't free. I sacrificed it. My girl show me love, she know I make sacrifices. And if it's real, real love, then you make sacrifices. To get ahead, man, you gotta make sacrifices. That's how hungry my appetite is. Yeah, yeah. I cut the drama out my energy. Focus on an inner me, never on an enemy. And I done sacrificed my own time. I done sacrificed my own mind. I done sacrificed the club life. I done sacrificed my love life. Look, I cut the drama out my energy. Focus on an inner me, never on an enemy. And I done sacrificed my own time. I done sacrificed my own mind. I done sacrificed the club life. I done sacrificed my love life.
Also, I done sacrificed the thug life. Diamond shining in no dog.
I'm Larry Ridley in Orlando. This is the NFL on EA Sports, and this is Madden.
Set to go now is Connor Barth, and we are underway from the Superdome. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. Room here to run. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race.
All right, let's give credit where credit is due. How about that return? Great blocking, great vision, all the way down to the 2-yard line. The only person who has to be upset, the guy who didn't get it into the end zone. That far and no reward?
Now a play fake here on first down. Flush to his right. And he will have a touchdown. It's their quarterback taking it in from 2 yards out. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. And they're in on the first play from scrimmage. Our crew and you and I, we better strap in here.
That's what's commonly known as quick strike. Points on the board. This could be a fun game.
And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
And he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
And he fires one that's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler Luke Kuechly that picks it. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Offensively, when you see cover two, the thought has to go through the quarterback's head.
drive the football when making throws. It's not just the deep guys covering. It's the guys underneath you have to be careful of. Drive your throw. Otherwise, you see what results? Interceptions.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
To throw on second down, Wade. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10 to the 7. That one goes for 24 yards.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
It'll be a pickup of 4, and it brings up second and goal.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Dancing to his left. Well, he told us he was going to hit the end zone a couple times in this game. I just don't know that he envisioned doing it in the first quarter.
He probably did. I'm not sure we did, right? Because all the great ones, that's what they do. They dream about it, right? They think about it. They envision it. They think it's going to happen and almost will themselves into it. I just look at what he's done so far and just wonder what's left to come. Let's sit back and enjoy this one.
And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. Just a 4-play drive that time, and it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This one taken from the 7. Now the Bears offense ready to take over again. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play and give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. A first carry now for Jordan Howard. And it'll work his way across the 30 to the 32. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. But you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one. And what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offense coordinator, let's run the football. Let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Brandon Gaughton, Charles Davis back with you as it's Bears football here to begin quarter number 2. They've got a 3rd down and 5 to start things out.
Let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
Glennon. And that is incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this 3rd down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. Taken in at the 22. There he goes, left side. And all the way in for the touchdown. Tevin Coleman, 78 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead.
When you've got a guy that fast back there to receive punts, that's a nightmare for the guy game planning, the special teams coach, but it's also a nightmare for the punter. Sometimes they get...
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And his throw's going to be incomplete. They've got this big lead. They said, forget one. We want two. Instead, they got zero.
Unbelievable they didn't even attempt it from the 15-yard line. What are they thinking? I do know this. When you fake one in this situation with that type of a lead, especially from the 15-yard line, oh, boy. I tell you what, meeting them again somewhere down the line, they'll remember this. Yeah, they'll think that they were trying to clown them a little bit.
And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And this is their third drive right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know can work and finally getting it done.
A reminder coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before that. Now Glennon, and unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. He was looking for Zach Miller, his tight end there, and that'll bring up second down.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. And this is complete to Zach Miller. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. They'll set up to throw. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
I know they don't like to hear it when they get to a certain age, but then you have to start to use your skills, your wiles, right, your mind to beat guys to the football. And getting your toes tapped in bounds definitely qualifies as that, doesn't it?
The veteran showing he still has the agility. Out left here, it's complete to Wheaton. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what?
And this is going to be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And a great return.
Don't draft a quarterback number two overall without that expectation. The fans are going to want to see their new toy, and every interception, as you said, brings them closer to wanting Mitchell Trubisky.
On first down, Wade. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. And off his back foot, he'll heave this one deep. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got some space here. And hell, running right through him. And he's brought down. That good for 19 at a first down.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
On first and 10, Wade. Escaping the pressure right. Now he'll go deep down the middle. Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. And he takes this thing down deep into Chicago territory. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Wade in the gun. And he's going to go down just outside of the 5, right around the 6-yard line. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. This is an easy one, 23-yarder. And his kick is indeed good. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Thanks, Brandon. And welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Wolves are up right now and are looking to keep up the pressure moving forward. The Bears won't panic either. They know they just need to take it one play at a time. So let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Bears on first and 5. Clinton's under pressure and will throw the pick. Keekly's is the one who makes the pick, halting the offense's drive. After the pick, offense comes out now. Wade's going to stay between the tackles. And a quick three-play drive ends with the score, which takes the lead to 13. Bears set the punt it away. Cole moves back for the puck. He gone as he sprints into the end zone. The lead now at 19.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. Let's field it at the 2. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Mike Glennon now and the rest of this offense heading back out. And he's had some time to chew on that interception he threw on his last drive back in the first half.
Well, normally we say you want to get him right back out on the field and play again, right? But as you mentioned, had the halftime, had to stew about it a little bit. Maybe he'll have a chance to relax a little and kind of laugh and chuckle and let it go.
He'll hope to respond positively here to start the third quarter.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. Second down following the run. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Dumps that off to his running back, Jordan Howard. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice gain.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
But if these guys are going to chop into that deficit, They're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
They go with Howard again, and that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll make it third and 13.
And that's another stop for the defense, something we've seen all game long. They have been on fire today. No matter what's called by the offense, they've had an answer for it.
So first and second down went the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and 13.
All right, here we go.
Off the play fake to Langford. Here's Glennon. And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
And attempted a deep ball there, and they didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage. Here's Pat O'Donnell now. Remember, his first attempt was returned for a touchdown. Now a high kick, almost a pooch punt. Well, pretty woeful there, just 23 yards on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. They begin the drive with Coleman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Back to throw. Wade buying time to his left. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. He got 29 yards that time. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
Coleman now. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. So it's our home team here in possession of the football as we come back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. Look looking to throw on second down. Wade steps away to his left. And some room to roam now. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay.
Delay of game, offense.
He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Wade on the bootleg. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
Off the bootleg, Wade. He'll buy some time right. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Coverage was very good that time. A nice job to smother him as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board. Third down. It's Coleman. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
One of the things I love about this game is there's a match of wits throughout the game. Who's going to get the advantage? Who's going to catch someone off guard? I feel like the offense thought they might catch the defense off balance with that play call, but unfortunately, that didn't work for them.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. It's caught outright by Graham. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work.
All right, Mr. Fantasy Champion. We just saw him fake a field goal, and the kicker has the opportunity to throw a pass. He completed it, but not for a first down. Does anyone get any points for that?
No, he just gets some pride going back to the sideline saying he completed a pass as the kicker. But the big thing here is they didn't get enough for the first. The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. They are down big. They have not scored a single point. I don't know. Are they so defeated at this point you just want to get in the locker room and get the heck out of here?
That is one way to approach it. Sometimes coaches say, that's it, okay?
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw out to the flat. That's complete to his running back, and he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. It's an 8-yard pickup, and all of a sudden here it's third down. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him
without weakening our overall defense. You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
He's going to let it fly. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 14. They find some open field here. Pat, there he goes, right side. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, you start to feel sorry now for the young man throwing the football. This is really turning into a disaster.
Listen, it's baptism. Right? This is almost a rite of passage. This young in the league, go back and find a Hall of Fame quarterback and check their records for their first 2 years, especially if they started the bulk of the games. I bet you'll find double-digit interceptions on just about every one of them. They have to learn as they go along.
The story.
Rather you than me. If you've been with me from Port of Miami, it's been a journey. Ain't nothing changed. A little stronger, a little wiser. Blame it on America. Whoa. I'm pulling off the lot, I bought it cash. Whoa. Her future bright, don't give nobody bad. Whoa. Be looking good inside the lot. Whoa. But I noticed that she missing all the edges. Whoa. I run the game just by running with the running. Whoa. Poor attitude, they got rich calisthenics. Whoa. Walking in the courtroom, sipping on the beverage. Whoa. I know the judge, so I got a lot of leverage. Whoa.
Tommy Lee. I make money. On my third passport in them. I got at the airport. I got Bowling Green dollars on my dollars. Busting down 100 in the bathtub. Get some house shoes. I got money. I got war wounds. Get the cushion on that. Ain't no dance moves. I was busted on the stoop. Hanging with my Haitians. On the news, on front page. Ain't no relations. I was stacking being, facing, bossing. 2 times in a row, that's a repeat.